Hello everybody. Today is a wonderful day because my pseudembrasia, they roll out just hatch, and boy are they big and beautiful. Just look at those eye spots. Pseudembrasidae rollei are one of the biggest Saturninidae moths you can counter in the mainland of Africa. The mainland does not include the islands, because that would be cheating with the giant Argema metriae, the comet moth. But still, these guys come pretty close in terms of wingspan, because they're absolute giants. These moths are from my own breeding. If you follow my YouTube channel, you will see that last year I've raised them successfully from eggs to adults. And if you're curious what the caterpillar looks like, you just have to type in the name Pseudembrasidae rollei on my YouTube channel, and you'll find multiple videos of me raising the caterpillars of this species. They're quite easy to raise on a very big variety of host plants. I used oak, quercus, but I bet they can also eat willow and cherry. And many more kinds of plants, because these types of polyphagous African silk moths, well, I said it, they're often polyphagous, so they're not a challenge in that regard. What's interesting is they wanted to hatch at the same time, despite being in the pupa for over a year, so that's interesting. And also good news, because it means their life cycle may be synchronized well. I hope this is the case, because this would increase my chances of pairings, because I need a male and female at the same time. Both specimens in this video are male, and females are even bigger. That's right. Can you imagine how big a female will be? Of course, with one of those hatches I'll film her. And usually the eye spots are not visible when they're resting. Only when they're startled. See? This moth is now starting to become calm, and the beautiful red eyes on its hind wings are now not visible anymore. So now it's well camouflaged. This is how it usually rests, and unless somebody annoys it, that's when it shows the eye spots. See? Oop, and it even tries to escape. That's my legs, by the way, in case you're wondering what that was. I'm not sure why I just filmed that, but I had the urge and I did it, so it happened. Thank you everybody for watching, and please stay tuned for more updates, because this is not the end of it. I hope to film a female soon if she hatches. Gotta be lucky enough to have one, but sure, it may happen. And otherwise, I have a lot more species coming. So thank you, and until next video.